today I'm just going around making my rounds, making sure there isn't any sign of bears, making sure everything's locked down, cleaned up. I'm just looking for basically prints, mess, things have been eaten or knocked over. Basically just little signs that something's been there and it's different from when I was there last.
As the winter thaw sweeps across southeast Alaska, the bush comes back to life. And on Chichikov Island, the onset of spring awakens a flurry of familiar hazards to the Brown family's remote lifestyle.
That looks good. Actually, we haven't seen any kind of sign whatsoever around Browntown itself. So right now it's just a precaution to make sure that everything stays tip-top and make sure that everything's okay.
In the months leading up to winter, the nine-member wolf pack united to achieve their goal of absolute independence.
I want to get as self-sufficient as we can possibly get. I want to stay home a little bit.
And although they were hindered by the departure of Brother Bam,
More girls.
The family realized their dream of transforming Browntown into a sustainable compound.
Yeah! Totally awesome.
Yeah.
But now, at the most crucial time of year for expanding their homestead, youngest son Noah is left to safeguard the family's Alaskan dream alone.
It's really, really, really hot.
This will be our key to staying cool. It's putting an extreme fountain in the place of fire. See?
Oh,
add into the fountain effect.
We have been in California now for 2 long months. It does lower everybody's morale to a degree because the blistering sun and everything just weighs down so much on people.
Oh, wow.
Ah, that's better.
This feels really nice.
Bring in our water.
We've had a major change in our life. It's kind of affected the entire family and everything we ever thought we were gonna do and have. Em started getting sick months ago, and we didn't know what it was, but it changed from the point of something's wrong to something's wrong.
Ugh. In recent years, contending with life in the bush, the Browns matriarch has overcome a battery of ailments.
Oh, do you hear that pop?
But despite her resilience...
No gutting it, Em. I mean, come on, be honest.
You know me, I can handle it.
Emmy is facing a health crisis that could force her family out of Browntown forever.
We started out with one doctor, and we ended up doing tests. We ended up with 3 doctors doing tests. They did one of those CT or MRI things on her throat. They were seeing nodes, as they called them. And so that doctor recommended that we go to another doctor, and we had the test done on her chest. That was the one that really floored us. He came back going, we need a biopsy, and we kind of need a stat. And things got very serious right then. I mean, the whole world changed right then.
Miles away from contact with the rest of the family, Noah must rely on a more primitive approach to his workload as the sole occupant of Browntown.
I'm just doing some laundry. I don't have enough dirty laundry to use any of the larger methods like the washer I made or the dryer. Pretty much with me, I only have really 1 dress shirt and a spare dress shirt. Yes, they look identical. I guess it's kind of something old-fashioned about having your gun on your leg and washing stuff up in the creek, like back in the pioneer days. Right now, everyone else is actually with Mom. She's having a bunch of medical stuff. I don't fully know what all is up. I just know there are more tests that are going to be done. There we go. I wouldn't say that none of my brothers could handle the job of staying here, but it definitely is something that I'm best suited for. Now, don't get me wrong, I want to get down there as quick as I can to be with her, but right now, if I'm doing what needs to be done, it's irrelevant where I am.
In the woods of Alaska on Chichikov Island, Noah remains cut off from contact with the rest of his family.
A toothbrush works really well for cleaning this. It's a good small scrub brush. Of course, who it belonged to before this, I have no clue.
Taking his mind off his mother's illness, Noah sets to creating a bush gift for his girlfriend.
I'm usually very precise and exact with everything that I do, but I think I'm being a little bit overboard on this project because of what it represents. I guess thinking about it, the way the shell is, you can tell the good years from the bad years. I guess it's a pretty good metaphor for a marriage or a relationship in general, because in the beginning, they're all good years, see? Then when you get married and know each other more, there will be bad days in there. It's just that at the end of the day, once you have finished everything, there's that little jewel inside. I wish I could give it to her right this second.
While the Browns must wait for the outcome of the test, Noah is alarmed by the arrival of a hungry intruder as his solitude is interrupted.
This would be the first bear I've seen near the property. There hadn't been any sign up until now, but of course you don't really need sign of a bear when there's one standing there.
The dense wilderness of Chichikov Island boasts the highest concentration of bears on Earth. And in early spring, these predators awake from hibernation with an insatiable appetite, which has Noah Brown on high alert.
The protocol for dealing with a bear is pretty much the same if there's a group of people or just one. Make sure that it knows that this area is yours, but stay out of its way enough not to bother it. We don't hunt bear, we don't kill bear, we don't hunt predators. Let it go through, but let it know that this is our turf. As long as the bears keep their distance, I'll keep mine. Being the time of year it is, the bears are starting to get up and about, kind of looking for food, coming out of hibernation. And I've sighted a couple of them, so I decided to go ahead and put back up the electric fence to keep all of them out. When I first put this thing up, I actually was able to convince Bear to touch it. I didn't think he really would. Want to touch this?
Whoa. Whoa. Phew. That thing is intense, man.
That's designed for bears.
Really?
Most likely one of my brothers wound this when they were taking it down. So it looks like it's... It looks like it's all still in good shape. I just need to reconnect some wires and hammer it all back into post before the bears come around. You can always kind of tell when there's a bear coming around because of the smell. The easiest way to describe it would be the smell of death. Right now, this fence is completely up and live. You can actually hear the fence popping. Being that the rest of my family isn't here, this is extremely useful. It makes it one more step of preventing any bears or creatures from getting into Browntown and having to do something more excessive to make them leave. It's been months since I have seen anyone from the family, really. Whether I'm here or there or Timbuktu, it can't change what's going on. It can't change what the test results are. It can't make people live or die. My physical location is irrelevant because I'm always with my mom, period.